everybody. This is Dr. Carmen Bright, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. You are watching Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. Thank you to all the new subscribers. Thank you for all the subscribers. And thank you to all of you that are leaving comments and you're emailing me. You know, I have the distinct honor and the pleasure of working with many of you guys in consultation and coaching. And it is truly an honor. And as I told you guys before, a lot of times you're wondering, What purpose does this pain serve? Or is there light to the end of the tunnel? You know, I was in your shoes, you know, a while ago, and I asked the same question. What's the purpose of this pain? How is this ever going to help anybody? How am I ever going to get out of this pain? But, you know, the blessing for me is that I had a good mentor. I had a very good support group, strong women that I'm around, strong men that I'm around. And with that came my healing. And now I'm seeing the fruit of my labor. I'm seeing now that even though that something things I chose without knowing, you know, I ignorantly chose certain things and relationships without knowing what I was getting into. There were red flags on the way, you know, through prior to the relationships that I ignored, like many of you. And but now, you know, I'm seeing the fruit of the labor. I'm seeing that my decisions, you know, to leave, to go no contact, to Gray Rock, you know, those decisions have paid off. And the way that they have paid off is by the gratitude many of you show and the success stories that you guys are telling me and the, you know, the joy I have from bringing you guys videos and talking to you, you know. So do know that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. You just don't see it right now because you're in the process of your pain. Go through that pain. And so that brings me to the topic, which the topic what many people keep asking is, how do I know when I'm ready to get back into a relationship? Well, now keep in mind that, you know, I'm not for everybody. And so a lot of times people are looking for answers because they want answers that they want. They don't want answers that they need to hear. You guys know, if you've been on my YouTube channel for a while, I'm a very straightforward person. I'm going to tell it like it is. And the reason why I do that is because of the way that I'm constructed, and my mentor had to tell me like it was, even if it really hurt my soul when she said what she had to say to me, you know. And at one point in time, I was like, does she even like me? You know, but she loved me. She loved me enough to tell me the truth and just tell it like it is to tell. And it hurt, but she was so right. And many people, the first thing you have to get a good mentor is going to tell you like it is. They're going to tell you things that you don't want to hear. Some of you are going to get mad, poke your lip out. And some of you make the big mistake by leaving that mentor. That mentor is for your good and not for your hurt. Now, if your mentor is hurting you, you might want, you know, when I say hurting you, like purposely hurting you, you know, there's a difference. But if you have a mentor who's going to tell it like it is, you know, they're concerned with your well-being, but is going to tell it like it is, that's the one that you want to stick to. It's not always going to be easy when you're dealing with pain, first of all. Second of all, a mentor should be able to tell you, you are not ready to date anybody. You should not be in a relationship at this particular time. But some people are hard-headed. Some people want to hear what they want to hear. They want to do what they want to do. They grown, and you don't tell me what to do, and you don't know me. But that mentor has been, that mentor should be a battle-scarred soldier. And when I say battle-scarred soldier, I don't mean, you know, that's a hypothetical statement. I don't mean that they literally have to be from the military, but that should have, they should have some wounds on them to prove to you that they have been through life and been through some things to teach you some things. So if you find a good mentor and they tell you, you are just not ready to date. A lot of people ask me, you know, do you think that I'm ready to date? Well, first of all, I don't know you. I haven't worked with you. And by listening to you and listening to your story and listening to the inflection of your voice, looking at your facial expressions, you know, using those analytic skills that I have and listening to you and hearing what you're saying that you're not saying gives me an indicator whether or not you're ready for dating anyway. The first thing is, if you keep on asking about dating, many people, especially like a lot of women, you know, grow up assuming that if you don't have a man, something's wrong with you. Okay. So as young as I am, I'm 32 again, you know, it's funny because I laugh and joke with my family about that. They're so accustomed to, you know, me being young and always having a boyfriend and always being in a relationship or situationship with someone, you know, the first question is always, you know, you're not getting any younger. I argue with that, but you're not getting any younger. You know, have you met anybody? I'm not looking for anybody. You know, even my dad, it's funny because I had to laugh at my dad. My dad never asked me these questions ever. And on my birthday, he asked me, he said, well, let daddy ask you something now. You know, you seen anybody yet? You met anybody? And I had to laugh. I was like, no, sir, I'm not seeing anybody. And I think, you know, because a lot of them don't get this kind of training. So, but a lot of times, what is wrong with you? Why don't you have someone? Society makes us assume that if you don't have someone by this age, if you're not settled down, if you're not married, if you don't have a boo thing, you know, that something is wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with you. And many of you grew up thinking that, you know, even though you may not say it, it's in your subconscious mind that I don't have value if I'm not with someone. I don't have any value if I don't have someone on my arm, or if I have a boyfriend or a girlfriend or a husband or wife. You base your value off of the fact that you're with someone. So you have value, so you can be seen. I'm not alone. I'm not this lonely man or woman sitting at home. Well, first of all, if you are lonely sitting at home, loneliness is something that you have to deal with on the inside of you, because there are many married people that are with someone that are really lonely on the inside. A person doesn't take away your loneliness. You can be with a person and you still are. I was married and I was lonely, honey. So that was a space taken up in the house, which I barely saw the individual, but I was married and I was extremely lonely, you know. And then when the person was gone, it seemed like I was happier whenever he was not in the home. And so you can be lonely and married. So if you are lonely, you have to deal with your loneliness first. You have to discover yourself. You have to do things that you haven't done before. You keep doing the same thing over and over again, and you keep getting in the exact same situations. Maybe you need to change what you are doing. First of all, stop thinking about being in a relationship. How do you come out of a relationship? Most people get out of a relationship, and after they're angry, they're upset. And, you know, right then you don't want to be with anybody. But after the dust settles, you know, the smoke settles and you're feeling a little better, the first thing that pops in your mind is, you know, well, the next relationship I get in or the next person that I date, I'm not going to do this. And I'm going to make sure. OK, well, you're thinking wrong. I'm just tell you like that. You're thinking wrong. You're already thinking of another relationship. So what you need to do is you probably need to change, you know, what you've been doing, because you keep doing, isn't that the definition of insanity? You keep doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result. You keep doing the same thing and you're expecting a different result. And then when someone points it out to you, such as a mentor, you come up with every excuse. I'm only talking to those that I'm talking to. If I'm not talking to you, you know, you, and if you get upset and you write comments, just leave the channel and go to another one that's going to tickle your ear. I'm going to just tell it like it is. But the thing about it is that you keep doing the exact same thing. And then when someone interjects, someone that cares about you, all of a sudden they don't care about you anymore. You're a hater, you know, and you don't want to see me do well. You don't even want to see me happy. You got someone, or maybe you don't, you know, but when they tell you like, okay, you might need to stop dating, maybe you need to focus on yourself. How do you get to know yourself unless you're by yourself? Most of you guys don't even like yourself, so you don't even want to be alone with yourself. Well, if you don't want to be alone with yourself, who wants to be alone with you? You know, you have to discover yourself. I discovered a lot of things about myself that I didn't know about myself. And yes, just like the rest of you, when I first came out, I was hurt. I was angry. I didn't want to be in a relationship. When the dust settled and I start feeling a little better, just like with the doctors, just because you're taking a medication and you're feeling a little better, don't stop taking the medication. Take it until the time that we prescribe you to take it, or your body becomes resistant to it. That's the same thing. You know, just because you're feeling a little better don't mean to jump into another relationship. That's like becoming an alcoholic. You know, you're addicted to people, or you're addicted to alcohol. So you think that if I drink, you know, I drink when I'm having a hangover, it'll prevent me from having a hangover. Yeah, it'll stop you from having a hangover, but it sure get you addicted to the alcohol, right? Because now you're dependent on drinking the alcohol to keep the alcohol level to a certain level so you don't throw up. You know what? Take your time and throw up. Take your time and review your life. Take your time and find things to do for yourself. Some of you were upset and was like, well, she's talking as if we have money. I ain't have no money in the beginning either. I had to start all over again. So you know what? You can go by the water. If you like water, go sit and watch the ships come in. And that sounds like sitting on the dock. Yeah, sit on the dock of the bay and watch the ships come in, you know, and go out. You know, go find something to do. Find a beautiful park. Go look at flowers. You know, walk around the mall. You may not have the money, but you know, and you shopping in your mind, you can come up with a lot of things. I'm save up money. I'm gonna get that one shoe, and I'm gonna come out and get the other shoe and put that on layaway. And then when you do have money, that's an ugly outfit. You don't even want the outfit anymore. You know, find something to do. Go back to school, get your certification, fix up your house, put money aside. There's a lot of things that you don't even know that you enjoy doing, or that get time with yourself. Go find a therapist. Go find a mentor, a coach that is going to tell you like it is. They're not going to tell you what you want to hear. They're going to tell you like it is. Most people are in love with the idea of being in love. Most people are in love with the idea of being in a relationship. You idealize the relationship and come up with this idea of what the relationship is supposed to look like, you almost do what the narcissist do. The narcissist picks people, and as they're going through different people, pick personality traits to create their own personality. You pick relationships and you pick qualities from those relationships, and you create a relationship in your head. Then when you meet someone, they don't qualify for what is in your head because that is not the person that they are. And so a lot of you are already in your mind creating a picture of what you're going to take and what you're not going to take. And a lot of you are not taking the time to heal. And I'm telling you, because you are not taking time to heal, being by yourself, if that's all you ever think about is your next relationship, when am I ready, then you are not ready for a relationship, because I promise you, you will pull in another narcissist worse than the one that you had. And this time, when people try to tell you, you'll dismiss it. No. And I've met people like that. They get into another relationship, or they're in a relationship with a narcissist, and I start pointing out things from there, from my videos and pointing out things, they will argue me. Well, no. I mean, I can see some of the traits, but that's it doesn't fit that category. Well, no. I'm very careful. No. And usually what I say is like, all right, no problem. Because I promise you, either you're going to be too embarrassed to come back to me and tell me that I was probably right, or you're going to start complaining about the things that they do. And I'll just usually sit there and stare. And sometimes people are like, I already know. I should have listened. Or people just don't come back to talk to me, period. And usually, even with on YouTube, you can tell when somebody's gotten back into a relationship. You can tell people that have recovered enough where they don't really need the videos, or they disappeared, or the things that they're saying now, that you could tell that they're back in a relationship. You could even tell when the coaches have gotten into a relationship with another narcissist, and all of a sudden they either disappear, or you don't hear from them, or even the way that they talk, or you can tell that they're angry, you know, so you can tell. So it take your time, discover yourself. You know, the beautiful thing about there's many beautiful things about my mentor, and she has a lot of mentees, put it that way. I'm not the only one that she mentors. But one of the many beautiful things is that she was with her husband for over 31 years, I think. And he passed, Bishop passed. And one thing, or many things, I'll just say one thing for now. She was a role model to us women. She is the epitome of womanhood. She is beautiful. She's sensitive. She's a very strong businesswoman, a strong woman. She knows how to, you know, she knows how to make things happen, but she's not a hypocrite. And whatever she teaches us are things that she does herself. Never from the day that her husband has passed have I seen her, and nor anybody else. She's a woman of quality. She's a woman of character, and she's a role model to follow. Is she perfect? Absolutely not. But you can't tell nobody that. You can't tell me that. But is she perfect? Absolutely not. But I watch her. I watch her as a businesswoman. I watch her as a pastor. I watch her as a spiritual parent. I watch her as a mentor. I listen to her. I honor her. I've never seen her creeping around. I've never seen her desperate for a man. None of that. Everything that she teaches us, she walks herself. She's not a hypocrite. And I honor and I respect that. And a lot of times what people don't understand is that if someone is telling you something, you have to look at the character of the person that's giving you the information. Are they talking the talk and walking the walk, or are they only talking the talk and that's it? If they're talking the talk and they're walking the walk and they're giving you an example, then you might want to listen to them, because they have gone beyond where you are at and they're still maintaining. And what they're telling you to do is exactly what they're doing. And I don't come on and tell you guys to do anything, just like with my soldiers. I used to tell my soldiers, I'm not going to tell you to do anything that I haven't done or I won't do. You know, as a young soldier, I used to have to do the exact same thing that I'm telling you. This is what I'm telling you guys to do as I'm doing this to look out for you. Don't ask me, just do it. And then when you come and finish it, come and talk to me, and then I will tell you why I did what I did while I'm doing this. But if push come to shove and we need things done, I will get out here just like with you guys, and I'm going to do the exact same thing that you guys are doing. I'm not a hypocritical leader. That's likewise when I tell you guys things. If I tell you something, my mentor has worked with me and works with me still, you know, because I'm going through different levels. And the same thing that I tell you guys, if I tell you guys something, I'm going to walk through it myself. And if you are so over concerned about dating or being with someone, then your value, it's almost like your value is connected with being with someone. Your whole concern, as long as you are over concerned about being with someone, it's not time for you to be with someone. You have to discover yourself. You have to be comfortable and happy. You're successful. You know, all these things are happening for you when you're single. All these things that you're doing and accomplishing, you know, you want to buy a home, you want to buy a new car, you want to open up a business. All these things you can do without interference, without the obligation of being in a relationship at that time. And then you have people that are jealous. You get, the narcissists are jealous. And so you never get to do exactly what it is you're wanting to do or to move forward in what you're trying to do. Be satisfied, because what will happen is you're going to be so satisfied if you allow it. You'll be so satisfied with being who you are and discovering who you are and that you are enough that when he comes or when she comes, you will even question, like, am I even ready to date? You know, I don't know. I kind of changed my mind. I remember when I changed my mind. I wanted to date and I wanted to have a boo thing. But I did opposite of what I was accustomed to doing, and I just wouldn't do it. It's not that it's not easy not to date. I mean, it's not that hard to date, but at the same time, you have to make yourself available to date. And I never made myself available to date. And then after a while, it got to a point where, like, oh, I'm a little selfish. You know, I don't think I'm ready to date. I don't think I'm ready to be with anybody else. And the longer that I am alone, the more I enjoy being around my spiritual mother, around my spiritual brothers and sisters, around my child, around my family, you know, doing things and talking to you guys. I mean, the time that and the effort that I take to make sure that I help you guys and talk to you guys, that time will be cut kind of short when you have another person in the picture, because it takes two people to make the relationship work, meaning that I would have to cut down on something to compromise, right? And at this particular time, you may get to a point where you're not ready to compromise like that, but you'll know, because all of a sudden this person shows up, and then you'll even question, like, I don't know if I'm ready to date. I don't know if I'm ready to share my space or my time. I don't know if I'm ready to share my home or move in with someone. I don't know. When you get to a point where you really don't want to, or you're questioning it, that might be the time that you're probably ready to date. But as long as it's on your mind all the time and you're always thinking, now, people are going to argue with that. People are going to make their own videos. You know, people, I don't agree with you. That's fine. Then my videos are not for you. But those of you that have been following me for a while and trust what I say, I'm telling you, you have to be satisfied with yourself. You have to be comfortable. If you are constantly thinking of a relationship, you are not ready for a relationship. If that's all that's on your mind, you know, and then some people make the excuse, that's not always on my mind, I'm just thinking. No, it's on your mind. It's on your mind. That's why you're asking. Because if you're still asking, it'll get to a point where you won't even ask. You won't have to ask. You know, you won't have to ask. You know, and when it happens, all of a sudden you meet someone, it's like, wow. But you still have to be careful, because if you have not worked on yourself and you're comfortable with yourself, you can still be vulnerable. So you can still spend a lot of time by yourself and being satisfied in what you're doing. That if you've never dealt with the root issues that caused you to be in these relationships in the first place, what is the magnet? What is the beacon? Go watch my mentor's video. She did one. It's transcriptural. Go. I posted it on my Facebook page. But she talks about the beacon that's in you, the beacon that was set from childhood that draws the narcissist to you. So if you have not ever addressed and shut down that beacon, if you've never went to reset your compass, if you've never went to look at your foundational damage, you're always going to build on a crooked foundation. And so it's best to get into counseling, get into mentorship, to work on you. Stop focusing on the other person. A person is not going to change. You can be in a relationship with a person and always focus on what they're doing. Once you start changing, and you start changing your mind, things start changing. When I was in the relationship 22 years and I focused on that individual and I was, you know, why this person won't stop cheating? Why won't this person stop doing this? Why won't this person, why? When I stop looking at the person and start looking at myself, why am I tolerating this? How much more am I going to allow to happen? You know, this has happened. This is never going to change. This has been exactly the same. When am I going to have the aha, the light bulb turn on? Like, you know what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. This person doesn't care whether you hurt or not. It's all about themselves. It's all about how they feel. It doesn't matter how you feel. They don't even see you as being a part of the relationship. They are the relationship, and it is what it is. And so when you have to make a decision, just like I had to make a decision that I change. When I started changing, when I began to have more value for myself, when I began to understand, you know what? I deserve better than this. I much rather be alone than to sit and be hurt and be lonely in the relationship than I can just be by myself. You know, I can do bad by myself. What is the song? I can do bad by myself. I don't need no help to starve to death, right? So I don't have to be in a relationship and hurt. I can come out the relationship and hurt for healing in the first place. So a lot of you guys are so focused on this relationship. I promise you, if you jump into one now, you're probably going to end up in a situation worse than what you came out of. Take the time for yourself. If that's the main concern that you have, and you have not dealt with that foundational damage, you have not dealt with how you are thinking, the way that you're thinking, why you're thinking, the way that you're thinking, what role did your family play in it, what has happened to cause you to magnetize a narcissist like that, you're not going to be ready. You have to do a lot of self-work first. Do a lot of self-work first and get yourself into a place where you're satisfied with you. You're happy with you. You feel beautiful. You feel accomplished. You feel handsome. You feel like you've done something. You feel, wow, I'm doing this myself for the first, where you are happy with yourself. When you are truly happy with yourself, you'll never depend on another person to make you happy. You'll never depend on another person to make you feel validated. You'll never depend on another person to make you feel valued. That's something that you have to do. Self-esteem. Your esteem is not established by someone else. You have to be that confident person. And when you are confident, narcissists are afraid of confident people because they're not going to get that far with them. They'll try them, but they already, they already gauge the amount of narcissistic injury they will sustain with a confident person. A confident person is not desperate for a relationship. And a narcissist, they'll try, but they're pretty intimidated because they know that you can do some damage. That's where you need to be. And those of you that come on is like, that's exactly where I'm at. Child, no, you're not. No, you ain't. Hush. And keep watching the videos. But you have to get to that point. Now, some of you really are. Some of you really are in that place. Well, it doesn't matter to me whether I meet someone or not. When you get to that point, you know, your heart's desire is to have someone, and that's something that you really desire, but you're at a point in like, you know, hopefully I'll meet him, you know, and if I don't, that's fine. You know, my heart's desire is to be with someone, you know, and but if it doesn't happen, I'm satisfied with me. I'm happy, you know, I'm happy. I have family, I have friends, I have a support group. You know, in order to make friends, you got to find yourself friendly. Isn't that what the Bible tells us? You know, for those of you that are Bible believers, but in order to be, you know, to have friends, you got to find yourself friendly. You got to be friendly. You got to be open to, you know, friendship and still keep your boundaries, you know. So hopefully that answered the question. Some of you guys are like, that is not what I was looking for. Then I am not the one you need to be listening to. But I appreciate you guys listening. Thank you so much. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It is Dr. Carmen Bryant, Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. Make sure you check out my mentor's YouTube channel too and subscribe to her channel. It is Helen Sadler, Destiny Helper. Make sure that you subscribe to her channel and make sure you share. You never know who you're going to help. You'd be surprised at the people around you that you're going to help. Some of you guys have shared the videos and talked to people and they have that aha moment. I can't believe this. And they finally got it. You know, also, I am on Facebook, Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. That's the one with my book cover on it. That's my book Facebook page. And then I have a professional one. And I just want you guys to know that I plan on merging the two together so that it's just under my book. And it's Psychological Health Consultants and Services, but I'm going to take it. I'm going to merge it with the Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. So everything is on one page. So you guys are welcome to subscribe, hit the like button. Make sure you look up underneath my YouTube video. For those of you that have asked to give, thank you so much for assisting me. Thank you so much for giving. I really appreciate it. That helps me to continue doing what I'm doing because the programs that I'm trying to create for you guys do cost, you know, and when you have an overhead, you're a private practitioner, you have an overhead, a lot of your money goes to your overhead of your business. And so the extra that you guys give me helps me to create programs and come up with different things that I'm going to present to you guys. I want you guys to stay tuned because I will be doing Zoom conferences during the weekday right now. I kind of have to focus on the business. I kind of felt guilty at first because I didn't get right to it. But now I don't feel guilty anymore. But so during the weekday, I have to kind of focus on the business and get my business in order. So on Saturday, when I have time, I'm going to sit down. I'm going to look at the Zoom conferences. I'm going to come up with some SurveyMonkey surveys so I can find out what time zones you guys are in. The different time zones, so I know when to do it and then what topics, because all of you guys are not at the same level. Some of you guys are in the fresh discard. Some of you guys are in the, you know, the grief process. Some of you guys are in the, I can't believe, how can I ever recover? Some of you guys have a lot of questions. And so I want to send out a survey so I can see where everyone is at. And you guys can make recommendations as to what do you want me to talk about. I'm going to try to make sure that it's an hour at a pretty nominal fee, you know, an hour. And, you know, I will have the opportunity to talk and kind of lecture and then open it up for, you know, those questions that you have sent me so that I can address questions. You guys can elaborate on your questions. I get to see you guys. Now, it's going to be limited amount of people because I can't have a whole bunch of people on at one time. And so I may have to do two or three per day, you know, to hit, you know, that particular time zone because everybody is in a different place with their recovery. And so if I do like East Coast, I may have like two or three conferences, you know, within that day. So it's like, you know, one at one time, maybe like at nine, and, you know, for you guys at 12, three and six, or if I get up early enough, 9, 12 and 3, so that, you know, each one of you different topic. And then you have that opportunity to be in either or, but I probably have to limit it to 10 or 15 people so that I can still manage it, you know, and with my assistant. And so I appreciate your patience. Just give me time during this week, you know, usually Monday through Friday, I kind of have to focus on the business. On Saturday, I'm going to focus on the conference, you know, that what we were talking about on live. And so I will do conferences at a nominal fee. I'm trying to get my books in. It takes a minute for me to get because, you know, you have to pay for bulk purchase. And so some of you guys are wanting to purchase the book from me. So, you know, just give me a minute. Let me get the bulk purchase in. And maybe that's something that I can also offer. You guys can purchase at the same time and I can add that into that registration fee and send it to you guys. And so I really appreciate your patience. Thank you so, so much. Please look up underneath the link. There is a sponsored link. It's called betterhelp.com/Dr. Carmen. For those of you that are looking for counselors that provide online counseling, that specialize in domestic violence, in psychological abuse, and understand like narcissistic abuse. I have it set up that way. You get a 10% discount when you hit my link. And also, if you are dealing with, you know, financial difficulties, you let them know they do offer grants to assist you. Try it out. See what you think. You know, I am not at this particular time offering counseling through BetterHelp. And even if I were, I wouldn't be able to go across state lines. So many of you guys are asking for counseling. I cannot cross state lines with my counseling license to provide you with counseling. Some of you guys are asking the difference between counseling and coaching. Well, coaching is just like being on a football or basketball team. You know, we create a plan. We come up with strategies and I help you maneuver. I help coach you through those strategies. That means even recommending you to get counseling, you know, recommending you to talk to certain resources, you know, helping you to maneuver through the game that the narcissist is going to play with you in a court setting. You know, so that is what coaching is. Counseling, we're dealing more of the mental health issues. You're dealing with the depression and the anxiety. You're dealing with the post-traumatic stress. That is not something that I can offer to you unless you are in the state of Washington. So I cannot provide you with mental health counseling, mental health, you know, none of that, you know, diagnosis, any of that. That is only for those that are in the state of Washington. So yes, I am doing telemental health, but it's for residents of Washington State. I am a Washington State licensed counselor. So I can only offer counseling, post-traumatic stress, depression, you know, these kind of things, recommending you to med providers, you know, helping you to cope with what you're going through. Coaching, on the other hand, I'm going to help you maneuver through this minefield that you're dealing with this narcissist. So there's the difference. So please, those of you that watch my videos and hear me say it, you'll turn around and send me an email to ask me the exact same question. I know I heard you say this, but can you? No, I cannot. I cannot provide you counseling outside of the state of Washington. And even if I was on BetterHelp to offer counseling, I still cannot do it except for the within the confines of the state of Washington. I did tell you guys that I'm looking to get my license in the state of Washington. Well, that will open up the doors for me to have a license in California, make it more, you know, make it more easy. And then I'm also, you know, making some plans to possibly set up offices when it comes to coaching, set up international offices, like virtual offices where I can come and travel and meet you guys face to face in the offices. So give me time to work on that. But now you guys see what your money is doing to assist me. So those of you that are giving, those of you that are donating money, I appreciate it. I appreciate it. I really do. And I'm so honored. But now you see what I'm doing with what you're giving me. These are all the things that I'm doing. And so this is a 12-month plan. You know, this is what I'm planning on doing. So you guys, whatever you send, whatever you donate, it helps to make this happen, because we're going to make this happen. And I am, as I'm also developing classes, you know, online classes. And as I'm developing online classes and creating a, you know, writing another book, those funds is what helps that happen. So anything outside of counseling, when it comes to narcissist abuse and that, that's what your funds are going to. And so I want you guys to know that. And I want you to know I'm so appreciative, and thank you so much for helping me. Now you guys go and be great.